4.4. Ravens Tuesday in here, so I got to turn on my glasses.
What's up, y'all? This is your girl, Tamaya Monique, and this is the one, a.k.a. Foxy Baby. Catch us live every Tuesday from 8 to 9 p.m. as we discuss soul, secrets, and sisterhood. Only on Power 4.4 Radio.
Having a wedding, birthday party, or other social or corporate event, contact Greenlight Entertainment today with our experienced DJs, quality sound, and professional service. We look to make your event the event. Check us out on the web at www.greenlightentertain.com or call us at 443-602-0648. With Greenlight Entertainment, you have the green light.
Hey, this is your favorite professional life coach, Garry O'Neal here. Make sure you check out the See.Plan.Do show every Tuesday night at 7 p.m. here on Power 4.4 Radio, where the people are the power.
Absolutely. Hey, let's take it down a little bit on Tuesday. What? You already know we only play a vulnerable artist when we win. I should have jumped, but here we go. Jazz first started doing this, I was a big guy and I was happy. I was like, look at him getting that L. Hey! Hey! First of all, two sideways lots of Vibras. You already know. You know the vibe. What's up, everybody? Every up, what's up, what's up, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the See.Plan.Do show. Welcome. Happy Tuesday. Happy Tune In Tuesday. Shout out to everybody who is checking the show out. You're either listening to it or you're watching it live. Guess what? You made it. It's another Tuesday, a great Tuesday. It was really nice today.
It really was.
It was really, really nice out today. And I'm glad that you're here. I'm glad you had, hopefully you had an amazing Tuesday. If you didn't, guess what? You're going to have a great Tuesday night. So, if you don't know me by now, we episode 11. It's 11. We 11 in the game, okay? But again, let me formally introduce everybody to the See.Plan.Do show. I'm Garry O'Neal, your host. A little bit about me, life coach, slash DJ, slash CPR instructor, slash I do whatever I want. I'm going to just start calling myself Slash. Well, you really can't get yourself a nickname, but somebody start calling me Slash, so that works. Okay? Guess what? So hopefully you had an amazing, amazing Tuesday. I got a special guest here with me in the building. Danni Byrd. Danni, what's up?
What's up, Garry? How are you?
I'm doing great. How are you? All right, let me take these glasses off because the Ravens won.
Yeah, because he made me take my glasses off.
I did, but you're gonna put them on.
Nah.
No, you had them on top of your head. You didn't.
You know.
You didn't. You had them on top of your head. I thought you were gonna put them on because the Ravens won, and every time the Ravens win, we're turning up. So, Jay, haven't we been doing this like five times already? Four times? Yeah. If we did that when the Steelers were, if I put these glasses on every time the Steelers won. They still be in the box right now. If I did it still every time, anybody else, they still be in the box. Let me put my regular glasses on. All right, so let's get right to it because this show is going to be absolutely amazing. I so appreciate and love all the guests that come on the show because you know what? They A1. Oh, multi-bella. They are A1 people on the show. So without further ado, we're going to get to Danni and everything that she's going to drop. She's going to drop that heat, that fuego. Speaking of fuego, hold up. Was that my phone? Is that my phone going off? Hold on. I got a new phone, y'all. If you don't know me, I had an S7. Hold up. I mean, I have a phone that, let me turn this off. See now? See, look. See? My S7 didn't do this to me. And now look at my phone messing up right on air. It's okay. Now I'm about to just turn it off. Look at that. I'm about to just turn it all the way off. You don't have those issues because you got an iPhone?
No, I have an iPhone.
I have an S10.
Okay, well, I have the 10. I have the Note 10.
Oh, is there a difference?
It's a slight difference in the Note. Just
like what kind of phone is your car compared to my phone?
If your car was what? It's a Galaxy. Okay. I'm just
I feel like she's being nice because she's on my show. Like I feel like I hear it in your voice. Like I feel like
it's okay. We're gonna
if your phone is a 10, if your phone is a 10,
but I'm a Note 10.
I know, but then, if you were to grade your phone, a 10, 1 to 10, your phone's a 10.
It's extra credit. It's just extra credit.
Yours is extra credit?
It's just extra credit.
Where's my phone?
It's A.
But yours is extra credit, though.
Yeah. It's okay.
I know my phone's feelings hurt right now. It's fine. It's okay. But guess what? See, look at that.
I won't meet you.
And you know I don't even talk about brands on here without them cutting a check. But okay. It's okay. All right, so.
You know, you don't have an iPhone, so I'm cool.
Oh, we definitely won't have those. Okay. Unless they send me one. And then I will have
it. Yeah, I'd use it if I had it, but.
Maybe let Logan and Lauren have it. So. But if they send me one, I will have it. If they send me one or they send a box to the show, Power 4.4 Radios here in Baltimore, if they send one, I will be using it the next day. All right, so let's get to the See.Plan.Do moment of the week. I like to entitle this one, It Was All a Dream. All right, I'm going to give you two pieces of this one. So Langston Hughes had this is a very famous poem, Harlem, A Dream Deferred. And it says, what happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun or fester like a sore and then run? Does it stink like rotten meat or crust and sugar over like a syrupy sweet? Maybe it just sags like a heavy load. All right, that's one piece of It Was All a Dream. Let me give you the next one. This is by Les Brown. Les Brown said, imagine right now, I want you to close your eyes. If you're listening to this, if you're in your house, not in the car,
If you're just chilling right now, I want you to just close your eyes and listen to this. Imagine you are lying on your deathbed, and surrounding you are the ghosts of the ideas, dreams, and talents that were given to you by life. And for whatever reason, you never acted on those talents. You never pursued that dream, and you never showed your leadership. And there they are, staring at you with large, angry eyes, saying, "We came to you, and only you could have given us life, and now we must die with you forever." The question is, if you die today, what ideas, what dreams, what abilities, what gifts would die with you? And that's Les Brown. Now, that's the two-piece for It Was All a Dream. Let me tell you right now, as you, any person that's listening to the sound of this sultry, smooth, velvety voice, let me be the first person to tell you, you can most certainly do whatever you want. Do not let your dreams die. Do not. I want you to be humbly aggressive about accomplishing your goals. We are in the last quarter of this year, and so guess what? With that being said, if you watch any football game, any sporting event, anything like that, when it's the last quarter, it's showtime. So we can't worry about what happened in January. You can't worry about what happened in March. You can't worry what happened in September. We're here right now. Don't let your dreams die. Don't let them die. You can save them right now. You can start the process. So don't let another week in this year. And guess what? This is the end of the, not only the end of the end of the year, but like the end of the century. Is it century?
I should have
Googled.
You should have Googled that fact.
Century, decade. Is it a decade?
What is it?
All right,
you should have
done. I'll look it up. But we are at the end, no matter what it is. Wow, my school stuff just came through.
Thank
but no
you
matter what,
public schools.
Thanks, Logan and Lauren. Right now, saying it's a decade, right? It's a decade.
That's what Jamae said.
Thank you, Jay. A decade. Thank you very much. This is the end of the decade. Don't let your dreams die. All right. So when we get back, we're gonna talk with Danny with episode 11, the keys. You got the keys?
I got plenty of them.
Listen, she's been ready since I've asked her to be on the show. So here is a See.Plan.Do song of the week. Hey, guess what? Power fans, I'm going to tell you who this is after it. But first of all, to Sabri Las Vibras. If you like this shirt, first of all, hopefully you already know what it stands for. If you don't, let me translate for you. You know the vibes. And watch this. Watch me turn around. Watch this. Do you see the logo on the back? Do you see the brand on the back? Listen, if you have a company or a brand or something that you want to promote, you definitely need to get with me. Right, Dan?
Yes.
Okay. I think she was talking to somebody. All right, so when we get back from the See.Plan.Do moment of the week, See.Plan.Do song of the week, we're going to jump right into episode 11, The Keys. Drop it, Jay.
Right here,
this way you be rapping right here, Jay. What?
Got it.
I feel like you should just drop a hot seat right now. Hey! I know you're feeling this song right now. She already, I told her about the song. I need you to do hashtag triple C right now. CCC for the candy corn fruit. Right now.
If I like it, I just want
to end it. Wow. Wow. This show is ending early just because of you. Hey.
All right, and we're back. All right, first, before we even get into Tuesday's topic, yo, let's talk about candy corn real quick.
Oh, God.
Danny, uh-huh. Do you like candy corn? Jay, cut the mic off. We're gonna go live with something else. We're gonna go pre-record. So you don't like candy? You don't like the deliciousness of candy corn?
Like if I saw a bag or a bowl of candy corn?
Yeah, if you saw a bowl of candy corn in here, what would you do?
I would not pick it up.
I can't even. How long have I known you? I've known you since
at least 20
90,
years.
Right.
At least 20 years.
And you don't like candy corn. Wow. All right, so I know people, let me go to your live real quick. Turn the camera on me. If you like candy corn, I need you to put an emoji or something like that right now. I know I'm not by myself in the candy corn crew. I already saw it. I ate some candy corn over the weekend. It had candy corn and it had chocolate covered peanuts. The vibes was real. Listen, you don't like that? What's your favorite candy?
Twix.
Okay,
Twix.
That's okay. Mm. It's not candy.
Reese's.
Kiss. Oh, I love Reese's Cups.
Yeah, I'm like, you know.
Kia's eating candy corn right now, she said.
Oh, my God.
You know what? Kia says she's eating candy corn right now. Kia, I'm going to send you a free See.Plan.Do coffee mug just because you eating it right now while you're watching the show. From now on out until the end of October, if you're watching this show, I need you to eat with some candy corn and take a picture and send it to me.
I'm sorry, you know what? I'm gonna have to
here we go.
Take it back a second.
Walk it back.
Gummy bears in the gold bag.
Okay, first of all, they're called Harbos. You should know the name of your favorite candy.
You know, some people just like, oh, the gold bag. Mm-hmm.
No, okay, I'm with you. Okay, so we can agree on that.
We can agree on that. But not candy.
And that's like, what we don't agree.
So that means don't go trick-or-treating at Gary's house.
First of all, there's not going to be candy corn being served at my house. Like, they will not get candy corn.
He's giving away candy corn.
And you know what? If kids come to my house for Halloween, I hook them up. Snickers, Twix.
So you're giving off the good stuff.
Reese cups.
Oh, okay.
And you know what? And maybe for the first five kids, I might throw them a king size bag. I might throw those king size
candy. Please don't give
candy corn.
I'm eating the candy.
That's like highly offensive. So just
to who? I can't believe you don't eat candy corn.
I'm gonna leave them alone.
This is just wrecked our friendship right now on the air that you don't eat candy corn. And not only do you not eat candy corn, you are anti candy corn. But you know what?
I just don't, you know what? I don't have anything nice to say, so I just...
So just don't say anything at all. Thanks. Thanks. Let's, what's your crew saying? What's people on your live saying? They like it.
My brother, for some strange reason, said Hershey's candy corn was good.
Sir, we don't give it to the brands. Come on. just say candy corn. Just you whip me on candy corn. Just hit triple C. That's what we're doing. All right, candy corn is great. Okay, I've seen a lot of candy corn slander. Let me tell you something. You don't like candy corn? Turn on your notifications. Let me know it's real. Turn on your notifications and let's have this talk face to face. You don't like candy corn?
Oh gosh, licorice.
Who said that?
That's horrid.
Delete that person right now. Licorice?
Licorice.
Like which? Okay, Twizzlers. What are you talking about?
I would hope he's talking about black licorice.
Black licorice? Like, no one likes black. Like, you know who likes black licorice? Psychopaths. Like, the Joker probably would like her. No, if you saw that movie's great. I want to talk about it, but I know people haven't seen it
yet. So
it's absolutely, I'm not going to talk about it, but it's absolutely amazing. It's an amazing top two Joker right there. All right, but guess what? That's enough of the banter. Even though I will be sending you chemicals. All right, so Ken Week. So first of all, that was Rotimi. That's Dre from Power. That the song was called Love Rhythm. I think I'm gonna put a CD together with all of my, you know, the vibe CD. I think I'm gonna have to do that. I think I'm gonna have to bring DJ G1 back out. Well, no, I'm old enough. I don't call myself that. I just call myself DJ Garry. But I think I'm gonna have to bring it back out with you know, the vibe CD. All right, so can we finally get to the Tuesday topic of the week?
Let's do it.
Episode 11, The Keys. So, let me formally introduce to everybody. With that candy corn. All right, let me formally introduce to everybody Danni Byrd. So, if you don't know this amazing woman, Danni Byrd is a licensed agent at Keller Williams Legacy in Pikesville, Maryland since 2013. She's been doing this for a minute. All right, she founded the Sapphire Homes Group in 2018. The team serves the Baltimore City areas and surrounding counties and has helped many. I know 12 people you help right now, has helped many buyers and sellers achieve their real estate goals. Danni, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
I'm so, so, so glad and honored and appreciative that you decided to drop by.
It's my pleasure. It's my absolute pleasure.
Good. All right. So I got a couple questions for you. I think you know how this goes, right? So you are, well, first, how is it? How is the real estate business? Is business good right now?
Business is good. Depends on what you want to do. We could have a more detailed conversation on that later.
Okay, great. All right, so you know what? I know it's a lot of people, especially around this time, people are looking to get a home. All right, if whether you're young or you're old, most people, their dream is to have that house, right? I remember when I got my house, I was like, oh man, this is it. Mm-hmm. Having cookouts in the back. Just chilling, being able to walk outside with my robe on because it's my house, mm-hmm. You know, stuff like that. Chilling out on the deck. Mm-hmm. I call the deck the See.Plan.Do Observatory. So I smoke my cigars out there. I chill. I love my house. Mm-hmm. So, of course, people, that's one of their dreams, that they want to own a house. So before they even get a house, Danni, my first question to you is, what do they need prior to that? Prior to getting a house, purchasing a home, what do they need to do?
Well, I guess there's several things that they should do.
Okay.
Maybe one of the first would be to just develop a mindset of ownership, something that you're going to take pride in. And anything that's worth having, it's going to take some planning.
Right. Okay.
So I would figure out first, you know, if this is what I really want, how can I prepare for it? Let me save. Let me start showing that I'm financially responsible on paper.
Mm-hmm. And what would that be like then? What would that mean? Showing that you're financially responsible on paper. What would that consist of?
Well, it consists of being somewhat financially literate. Having, you know, having an idea of what your credit score looks like.
Okay.
Which your credit score is basically a, you know, it's a digital report of how, you know, it's your financial report. That's okay. Digital. So it just kind of shows how responsible you are, if you're able to, you know, borrow money and pay it back on time,
mm-hmm.
Not abusing how much credit they give you, you know, making sure that you have savings, that you aren't, you know, maybe having a lot of overdrafts in your bank account every month.
Yeah.
Just, you know, kind of showing that you can maintain your status of life.
So being financially, fiscally responsible, financially mature.
Yeah. Because
I
have to be perfect.
Right. It doesn't have to be perfect, but you have to say, hey, can I afford this house?
Yeah.
Right, I think and if you haven't had a house, if you're in the buying process, they will scrutinize your stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like she
big
said,
time.
Overdress. Like I had a whole bunch of them, And they were like, hey, what's up with this?
What are these?
Like, these fries that you bought, what's up? What's up with these fries? Yeah. This candy corn bag, you got the house.
Yep.
All right, so okay, so just making sure the first thing that you would say to people who are interested in buying a home is to be fiscally responsive, financially mature. Mm-hmm. Sounds good?
Sounds good.
All right, so can you break down, I'm not asking you to go intensive, but can you break down the home buying process for us?
Sure I can.
Go.
So say if I met you and today and you told me that you wanted to buy, I would sit and, you know, go over a couple things with you. I won't ask you anything too intrusive because my job is to represent your best interests in a real estate transaction. So what I would do is have you speak to a lender that I know and use and trust on a regular basis because I know how they work. They know how I work. And ultimately, our goal is to get you into a property. So they're gonna ask you all of, you know, like, what's your social security number? How much you make? Show me your pay stubs. You know, they're going to kind of look at your financial picture and they'll take it from there. They'll let you know based on what you make and how much your debts are, how much house you can afford to buy. They're also going to look at your credit score. Mm-hmm. It does matter. It doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be, you know, 850, 700. It doesn't have to be that high. If it is that high, great. But typically they want you to be at a 620.
So a minimum. All right, guys. So if you're looking to get a house, at least hit 630, right? At minimum.
You want to be somewhere in that range. You know, and then they'll let you know, like, hey, based on the information that you shared with me, this is how much home you can afford to buy. This will have you at a payment of, you know, whatever. Depends on what the amount is. And usually your mortgage payment is cheaper than what you pay for rent.
So
what you're paying for rent, you could probably get like a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom home with a finished basement, backyard.
With the same money that they would probably use for it.
Yeah, with the same money that they're paying for a 2-bedroom apartment.
All right. Hopefully, everybody's catching this right now. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So, I'm looking to buy a home. If I'm a person that's looking to buy a home right now, what should I be looking for as far as this home? What should I be looking for? So, now I have my credit. Mm-hmm. You done hooked me up with a great team that can tell me, hey, you can buy this $2 million home. Mm-hmm. What should I be looking for in this home? What should I be looking for?
If you look for a spouse, if you were out here looking for a boo, a man, a husband, whatever you was looking for, you would figure out what is it that I want in a person long term. This house is the same.
Oh, wow.
You're going to be committed to it, right? Because a mortgage, you know, the mortgage payments are 30 years. Mm-hmm. It's a 30-year commitment. So you think about, you know, let me look at the neighborhood. Let me see if the schools are important to me, if you have kids or not. You know, where am I going to park? How many steps are here? You know. Maintenance, you'll just think about all of those things and figure out, you know, does this look like somewhere that I could stay for a while and be comfortable?
Okay. All right. Got it. I remember when I got my house, I looking back, the only thing I wanted to have was a dishwasher and a finished basement and a nice backyard. So we got that. I was like, yes, that was pretty good. All right. So what typically would stop a person from getting home? Like, what would get a person rejected? Hey, we can't do this. What typically would get a person out of there?
Well, a couple things may stop you from qualifying at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them could be, you know, like we mentioned, if your score isn't where we need it to be.
Got it.
You may have too much debt. So your debt to income ratio may be too high. That may affect how much home you're able to afford. Also, your employment. You should be on your job for at least 2 years. They want to see that you've had steady employment. Even if you've changed jobs, as long as you're still in the same, you know, like in the same field of work, then it's okay. Mm-hmm. But they want to see that you're at least, you know, maintaining steady employment for a good period of time. You know, so there are a couple of different things that come into play. Everyone's situation is different.
Okay.
I think a lot of people have horror stories and say, oh, I had such a horrible time, or so many things went wrong. But you know what? It's like a relationship with a person. Everybody has ups and downs. So.
Absolutely right. I hear that. Yeah.
Some people are great. Some people have no issues. Some people have a few bumps in the road, but you can get there.
Okay, great. All right. So what are some myths or misconceptions that people, like you said, people have horror stories. You might have heard about a person that, like, oh, I had to go through this, I had to go through that. What are some myths or misconceptions that people have about buying a home?
There are a few. So I guess some that really come to mind is that they think they have to have perfect credit. You don't.
So you don't have to have 850.
No, you don't.
900.
No.
Can you even get that?
No, I don't think you can even get that.
If I had 900 credit, I swear to you, I would just walk in anybody's house right now. And I would just say, I like this house.
And you know, an even bigger one is that they think that the higher their score is determines how much house they can buy. Like, oh, I have an 800 credit score. I should buy this $500,000 house. Oh. No, it's not. It's based on your income.
So if I have 800 credit score, but I only make $8 a year.
Yeah, you ain't buying that.
Not $8 a year. Okay. I didn't know that. Okay. Yeah. All right, what else some other myths and misconceptions you have here as far as that?
That they have to put down 20%. You don't.
You know what? I heard that a lot.
Yeah.
That was a number. Like, hey, like 15 and 20%. Now, where did that come from?
If you're buying an investment property, you have to put down 20% because you're not going to occupy it as the owner.
Oh. But if you are purchasing it to live in, then you're saying, hey.
You live in, and it will be your primary residence. And it also depends on the loan type that you use. Like different, you know, there are different loans. There's FHA, conventional, VA. There's a USDA loan too, but that's, nobody really uses that too tough. That's for like rural areas. And there are some areas in the city that are rural.
Okay.
Or classified as rural.
Oh, okay. All right, great. So you don't have to have amazing, stellar credit. And even if you have that credit, you can't just get whatever you want, right?
They finance most of what you're buying. So if you're buying a $100,000 house, if you use an FHA loan, you have to put down 3.5%. So if the house is $100,000, the bank will give you $96,500. You need $3,500 out of your own pocket. And then there are ways to cover that because people figure, oh, I don't have any money saved. I need a bunch of money to buy a house. You need some.
Okay.
But you don't need a whole lot. And you know, the average first-time buyer, if they're buying in the, 150 range, 130 range, 175 range, their down payment is between $4,500 and, maybe $6,000. You can get a grant. Some are grants, some are real grants, and some are deferred loan programs. Mm-hmm. But they give you at least $5,000 or more to cover your down payment. So then you don't really need anything.
So if you are looking to purchase a home, or you're interested, at this point, you need to already be fiscally responsible. Mm-hmm. You need to already have some money in the bank. Mm-hmm. You have to prove that you make this money. Mm-hmm. And just sort of be within your means, right? So that's what it sounds like.
Yeah, and they're not going to let you live outside of your means either. So even if you said, hey, I want to pay this payment on this $350,000 house, the bank is going to say, no, you can realistically only afford a payment of around $250,000. And that's all they'll lend to you.
So I can't right now just say, you know what, will LeBron live at? No? Prince, where's his estate? They definitely wouldn't even let me in the gate. They'd be like, no, sir. Probably. Right. Okay. All right. Cool. Okay. So that's a lot of great information. Thank you for that. That's a lot of great information for mine because, why, let me ask you this. Why do you think people sort of just go with rent first? I remember when I was a young guy here in the streets, and I remember I had a one bedroom. First of all, the amount that I paid versus what I would pay now, I think I was paying like $600 for one bedroom. Mm-hmm. Parkside Gardens. Shout out to Parkside Gardens. They're definitely not listening. No, they didn't. Hey, listen, Parkside Gardens. I remember paying like $600, one bedroom apartment. No one could tell me anything. I had two air conditioners. The vibes was young and budding then. So what do you think it is that people just sort of just go straight to rent? You just said that the amount that somebody would pay for rent right now, they could live in a very, very nice home that's theirs. So what do you think is the issue?
Well, I don't want to give the impression that I'm anti-rent. I think especially if you're a young person and you're first moving out on your own, it may be okay, and I guess it depends on the individual. It may be okay to rent for a year or two just to get a taste of how it feels to really have
taste of those bills.
Yeah, like this is reality. These bills don't stop.
I have to buy these macaroni cheese myself.
Right. Whoa. Like, that was a culture shock for me when I first moved out and I had to buy a laundry basket. And I came home from Walmart shocked. I was like, Ma, this laundry basket is $15. Yeah, that's why I fuss at y'all about tearing up my laundry baskets, you know? So, I mean, I think it might be okay to rent just to kind of get a feel of what, you know, what it's like to have to pay, okay. You know, rent, gas, electric, okay. Cable, whatever, groceries. But other than that, I think a lot of people just don't know. They just think, you know, hey, you know, I'm not going to be here that long. I'll probably only stay here for 5 years. 5 years is long enough.
That's a long time. Yourself.
Yeah, you know, I'll stay here for 2 years, 3 years. Okay. And sometimes people rent and stay in their house forever.
Okay, so we're both parents. Mm-hmm. So as a parent, when should I sort of talk to my children about owning a home? Because there are some cultures where they primarily focus on, hey, you know what, you're 21, you're 22, let's get you in the house. So that way, by the time they're our age, they might already be almost done with their mortgage. Whereas sometimes different cultures, we drive straight by an apartment, we get a car, that's it. So when should a parent sort of have that conversation with their children?
Well, I think, well, there's several things. One, I think that we as, I hate to say that we as a people, but yeah, it's true. I think like we as a people and as a culture, we are not taught financial literacy.
Absolutely.
So we don't know. Like we think that, you know, we graduate high school, we go to college, they offer you credit cards at this crazy high interest rate. We take it. They give you a $1,000 credit card. You think I have $1,000 to charge on here. No, you don't. You should really only utilize 30% of what they give you. So if they give you a $1,000 credit card, you should never use more than $300 on that card at a time.
Say it one more time.
Let me say it for the people in the back.
No, for me. Here. Listen, okay, go ahead. No.
We're not going to call no names.
You're right. All right, go ahead. So how much, break it to it down one more time, go ahead.
You should never utilize no more than 30% of what they give you on a credit card at any time.
Okay, all right, so since we're talking about credit right here, and again, talking to Danni Byrd, amazing realtor here on the See Plan Do Show, episode 11, the keys. Do you hear these keys? Do you hear them? She's dropping. Okay, so what about, bad credit or no credit is just as worse as bad credit? Is that true?
It is true. It is true. Because now you have to establish yourself.
Right.
You could do it on a small scale if you want to. So some things that I tell people, go out and try to get yourself, you know, an easy card to get is Kohl's, the department store.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. Kohl's?
Kohl's.
Okay, we don't talk about companies on here without them cutting a check, but...
You know, Kohl's. Okay. Or Finger Hut. All right, let's be real. Who grandmother had a Finger Hut catalog?
I think my grandmother's still paying for a Finger Hut card right now.
Right, okay.
She's still like $7,000 right now.
Well, you know, but he's throwing her under the bus.
No, she's joking.
Why are you throwing her under the bus?
I love my grandmother. All right, so get one of those. What about a secure credit card? I've seen that a lot. I'm pretty sure a lot of people have seen that.
That's a good way to get started.
Okay, because with the secure, you're sort of paying, you're putting up the money up front, and then you're sort of using it.
Right.
Okay.
But you just want to make sure that whatever it is something that is reporting to the bureaus every month.
Okay.
But just don't. So, you know, you ever hear when people say they maxed out their card? So if they got a $1,000 card, they used all of it. They charged the whole $1,000. Right. Don't do that.
30%.
Right. So, you know, look at it as if I loaned you $10.
Right.
And I loaned you $10.
Oh.
And both of you said, yeah, I'll pay you back.
Right.
But you came to me with a more detailed plan. I'm going to pay you $10 a week. Every week for the next 10 weeks. Whereas though you just pay me, you know, $10 or $20 every time that you get paid. You know, and I have it this week, you might skip me in there. But eventually both of you pay me back the money. Right?
Yep.
If both of you came back again and asked for a higher amount, what do you think I'd be more? Yeah.
Of course you
would. I'd go with him.
Two separate lessons.
Because it shows us a borrow and, you know, repayment pattern. And it shows that you have a strong pattern to say, I'm going to pay you back, you know, on time, consistently.
Okay.
Without missing a beat.
So not living above your means, making sure that you have a credit card that you're not using more than 30%. That was a key number, right? 30%. Wow, that was really good information. Wow, that was really good. I wish I would have had somebody like you when I was like 30.
See, and this is why I talk to people, even if they say I'm not ready. You don't have to be ready today. If you know, like, hey, my goal is to do this next year, let's talk now.
Okay.
And let's come up with a plan that you know that you can stick to and that I can hold you accountable to.
Right.
And make it work.
Got it.
Because credit is really, like, building credit and establishing credit is really just a game that you play. Just to show, like, hey, you know, I got the juice. I can borrow it. I can pay it back. Don't even, you ain't got to worry about that.
Got it.
That way you know anytime you swipe that card, it's there.
Okay. Oh, that's great. Okay. So, all right. So we talked about buying. Great info about buying. Some people, they want to sell. Now they want to sell. They want to flip. Is selling, is being a seller and flipping houses the same thing? Somebody asked me that before we came on the show.
Anybody, I mean, anyone that owns a property can sell it.
Okay.
Which I'm on a hunt for people that need to sell, by the way.
Okay. You want people to sell.
Anybody that needs to sell, wants to sell, thinking about selling, I need to talk to them.
Okay, okay. So, if I'm a seller, what should I do now to get my house prepared to put it out there?
Talk to me.
Okay.
Let me walk through that house. Let me let you know if any repairs that you may have to make. You know, we'll go over what your numbers are, how much you owe, how much you're looking to walk away with. Set your expectations up high. You know, set them up high in the beginning so that way you know this is how this can go.
Okay. So my house is probably like 200,000 right now, so maybe like four back.
I don't, well, you know what? I will say this. Do not look on Zillow and think that the Zestimate is how much your house is worth. Because Zillow hasn't seen your house, has it?
I don't think I've seen my house.
I don't think so, right?
Okay, so
it's just a computer algorithm. So a lot of people look on Zillow and say, yeah, I think my house is worth this. No, that's not true.
So they should get with a licensed realtor who can go through, preferably you, definitely you.
Definitely.
Actually, matter of fact, don't go to anybody
else. That's a no-brainer.
Go right here to Danny.
That's a no-brainer.
And then you're going to walk through, and this is where you would sort of give a good estimate. All right, should they start? And of course, they should start. If obviously there's repairs that need to be made, what else can they do? Is there anything else that they can do outside of making sure they have this stuff?
Sometimes we have to have a come to Jesus talk
with
sellers because they may think that their house is the best house on the block. But one thing I specialized in, when I first started, I primarily worked with nothing but buyers. I think my first full year real estate, I served 19 buyers. And then I think every year after that, I've kind of just grown my numbers more and more every year with just buyers. So I was extremely buyer heavy. So I got to know what buyers look for, what they want. And I see so many houses every day. I know what the market looks like.
Okay.
So I can let you know, like, hey, you might think that this blue wall in your family room or in your living room is perfect, you know, and a great color for you. But realistically, buyers aren't looking for houses with blue walls. You know, they probably want something more neutral.
Okay, so sort of set your house up, not where you had it, where you had purple walls or stuff like that. Just sort of make it very basic so that we can fit their
image. Because whatever color palette you have or design you have, even your decoration, it's okay because how we live is not how we sell.
Oh, okay.
So you got to think, like, this is how I want to live in this house. But someone else has to come in here and envision themselves living in that space.
Right. But if I have these paisley colored walls or polka dot walls, they're like, no, it might just turn them completely off. Makes sense.
And the first thing they'll think about is, oh, I don't like that color. I'm going to have to paint that or pay somebody to come in and do that. That's a bill.
Okay.
I don't want a bill. I want to walk in and just bring my stuff and start decorating and have fun. I don't want to have to come in and do work. So they'll start trying to discount your house for you.
Okay.
So just take away anything that you think.
So just make it bare vanilla ice cream. That's it. Okay.
But
so just make it as basic as possible. What would be something that you're like, hey, you know what? This would boost your, if I'm selling a house, what would be something that, hey, I could do to my house that would just boost it? Like, I know some people have carpet, some people have hardwood. Like, I know I have hardwood floors. Like, you know, I have a nice manicure lawn. I do, shout out to my lawn care people. Yeah, they're great. So what would boost, something that would boost?
What would boost your value?
Yeah.
I would say making any upgrades. If you know that your kitchen hasn't been done in 20 years, you might wanna do that. If your bathroom is old, cracked, if you have a blue, powder blue, baby pink, yellow, you know, Brady Bunch bathroom, you might want to redo that.
Okay.
You know, things like that. You might want to come in and make some upgrades because your neighbor can probably sell their house and get a whole lot more than you because they've made some upgrades.
So get with Danni so she can upgrade you. You know what? I'm going to upgrade my stuff. I think I'm going to set my own. No.
I like it. Yeah, you got to keep it.
I do got to keep it.
You got to keep it.
Yeah, I let the kids have it. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's time to give your kids, you know.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. Well, all right, so, okay. So last question, maybe the last question. What advice would you give a person? I mean, you've given tons of advice. What last, if somebody just tuned in right now, but I know you guys have been listening the entire time because I know you want to buy a house. I know you want to sell a house. You already know the content king right here. You already know what I have. What advice, lasting advice would you give to a person and say, hey, you know what? I'm getting into this. I need a house. What lasting, just one tip that you would give them?
I would say trust whoever you hire.
Oh, wow. And do you think that sometimes people don't trust their realtors, their real estate agents?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they don't know. They figure you know more than I do.
Okay, so you got a person that's coming in. So, okay, so you have a person that you feel like, hey, they may not trust a real estate agent, right? Because they like, oh, I was on Zillow, or you know what, this estimate. So trust your person. Okay, all right, great. All right, so this is promo time. Please tell everyone how they can contact you. How can they get with Danni? So listen, let me tell you this again. I'm only gonna have look. Yeah, get the camera on me. First of all, you see the shirt? Two Sideways Las Vibras. You know the vibes. You can get that from Lalone Clothing, L-A-L-O-N-E clothing.com. Get that, and then I want you to wear it. Wear it out. Because when they see you, they're going to know the vibes. Right? Okay, so Danni has sold a lot of people I know. She has most certainly sold them a home. And she is absolutely the best person I know to sell homes. Like, get a home from her. Throw a housewarming party. Invite me over. So I can spend the night. All right? So, Danni, how can people... Somebody right now is supposed to buy a home. Somebody right now wants to sell their house tonight. Well, not tonight. Because it got paid in there. So how can they get in contact with you? Please drop your promo right here.
You can find me on Facebook. My name is Danni Byrd on there. But I'm easier to find on Instagram at Danni B Sells Baltimore. Also, my group, the Sapphire Home Group, has a page on Instagram as well. And that is Sapphire_home_group. So you can always find me on social media. I'm always accessible by my phone or my email. My email address is DanielleBird@kw.com.
All right. So drop the email address one more time.
DanielleBird@kw.com.
Listen, get your house. You already heard her say earlier, it is much more lucrative to just get a mortgage than it is to get rent. Right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Wow.
Because I'm sure, like, you know, if you found out what people were paying for rent, you probably paid way less than that for your house because you bought it a while ago.
I did.
When I hear what people pay for rent now, I'm like, oh, my God.
I know. Like, I
cringe. I know. Like, I feel like an old lady. I cringe when I'm like, dear God, you paid what?
Yeah, I'm actually old. Like, I went to Morgan State's home group. Shout out to MSU. Shout out to the Bears. Yo, I'm old. I'm done. Streets is done. I went there thinking I was going to be young and hip. Nah, man, I'm out. They were like, excuse me, sir, can we get past here? And I was like, wow, Streets is done. I can't even, wasn't even trying to do anything. I was just standing there, just being old. That's it. Just got my home. I know, I was like, you know what? I'm going to let the little young kids do their thing. I'm not trying to learn any dances. I'm not trying to learn none of that. I'm just trying to just chill. You know what? Next year, I'm going to wear a sweater. I'm going to get a Morgan State sweater, like with the M on it. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. That's it. I'm done. Streets is done.
Okay. The street lights is on. It's my bedtime.
Yeah. What?
I'm happy about that.
Can we talk about some of the things that I definitely could go back in time machine and tell my younger self? Naps? Excuse me? I used to fight naps, Jay. Excuse me?
I don't know what a nap is.
Gotten away from naps? What? So, yeah. So, thank you so much, Danni, for coming on the show.
Thank you for dropping that knowledge.
Again, please, if you're looking to buy a home, if you're looking to sell your home, you're looking to flip your home, you're looking to do something with real estate, please get with Danni. She is the best that I know. All right? Tell her Garry sent you. Don't know if I'm going to get a cut. I think I am. I should. James, are Michael? Because I didn't hear anything.
I'll get you some candy corn. I'll get you some candy corn.
I can buy my own.
Wait. I'll get you some gourmet candy corn.
Any candy corn is gourmet, first of all.
I think that's debatable.
So let me get this straight. Let's talk to the viewers. So I just said that Danni could probably get somebody's house. So somebody buys a $200,000 house, and you're going to give me candy corn? Let's just get it on both. So I'm going to get candy corn every time somebody buys a house? Deal. Yes, that's what I want. I want candy corn. Right. Gourmet candy corn.
Deal.
Like okay. Truffle I'll candy put, corn. Like I'll gold. Put, like it has to have
it.
Gold.
I'll put a ribbon on it.
No, I wanted to have gold. Like little gold? Flecks of gold in it.
Oh,
you
can do that.
That's gourmet.
You can do that.
That's upper room level. That's the vibes. All right. Guess what, guys? We've talked about candy corn. We've talked about wealth. Hey, remember, what's that magic number? 30%. So don't go past that. In your credit cards, make sure that you're financially literate, make sure that you're financially mature, and you can get a house. You can get one. Just get one. I know that's your dream. I know that's what you want to do. Mm-hmm. Right? Let's stop paying this rent. There's nothing wrong with rent. But guess what? If Danni just told you just now, hey, you will get something way better that's yours, just start owning your stuff. Okay? But guess what? That's our time for the day. This was an amazing show. Yes, Jay. Oh, Jay got something. Hold up.
Oh, what you got? What you
Whoa.
What is the average mortgage that somebody would pay? Just the average. Just the ballpark. Because most people paying like $1,200 for rent.
Okay. You for
a house.
You are?
Oh. You grab you cut your purse?
No. $1,200 is okay. For okay. $1,200, that's like a renovated row home.
You know, when we that's taking this into overtime, man. Yeah. The one and twins, they can wait. We're going to go right into overtime. Let's go into overtime. Can we go into overtime?
That's how you feel? Okay.
Do you see the shirt? Don't you get from LaLongClothing.com?
I see.
You know the vibes, right? So we're going to eat. All right. So $1,200, is that a pretty good amount?
For like a first-time buyer? Yeah.
Okay. Cool. What about refinancing? Should I refinance my home right now?
Depends on whatever the going interest rate is and what your interest rate is that you're currently paying.
Okay.
But if you can save some money.
Save it.
Yeah. While interest rates are low, like now, interest rates are low. They have been low for a while. Yeah. Like they've been like historically low. Like, you know, 3-4%. Like that's pretty good.
So 3-4% is low. So
I remember I got screwed. One of the things that made me get into real estate was the first house I bought, I was 23. I think it was 23,
24
when I bought my first house.
2 years ago. Hey, Danni! You definitely look the same as when we were in high school. You definitely look the same. You definitely do. If I pulled up a picture of you right now, they'd be like, she was a...
I'm not going to be focused.
Oh, yeah, focus.